Well, it's a suggestion that has a lot of people talking. Could the border between New South Wales and Victoria come crumbling down next month?
Yeah, Business New South Wales Chief Executive Daniel Hunter and CEO of the Victorian Chamber of Commerce Paul Guerra have a plan to create an interstate travel bubble before the rest of Australia reopens, and they join us now. Thank you for your time this morning, guys. First to you, Daniel. It's a bold plan considering Victoria's cases are substantially lower still than New South Wales. You're also asking two opposing premiers to work together on this. Is that asking too much?
Well, I think spring is in the air. It's full of hope and optimism that we're going to be coming out of this pandemic sometime soon. New South Wales and Victoria make up 60% or so of the national economy. We're actually at similar rates of vaccination. We're at similar places in COVID. We're both in lockdown. We see no reason why New South Wales and Victoria can't come out of this together, have a similar roadmap, get the borders open, get some certainty. Let's lead the way for Australia.
I think a lot of people would be nodding along with you. We know that regional New South Wales is still cut off from Sydney, however. Should we not aim to get New South Wales together first?
Well, sure, and that roadmap at 70% for vaccinated people actually opens up, and that will actually open up very quickly in about 2 to 3 weeks. What we're saying is we actually know when both of those states are going to get to that 80% double vaccinated rate. We actually know that with some degree of certainty right now based on vaccination rates. We should give people certainty and businesses certainty that we can open up together, we can open up the border, we can get people making their travel plans, their Christmas plans, tourist spots can gear up for it, businesses can gear up for it, and we can get on with our life. We're in this situation where New South Wales and Victoria can lead us out. We can live with COVID. We're learning to live with COVID. We've got high vaccination rates. Let's go together and lead the way.
Yeah, I am all for this. Paul, how much would this give businesses a light at the end of the tunnel?
Oh, it's significant. I mean, we're living the longest lockdown almost anywhere in the world very shortly. So we need this hope to be able to get businesses up and running again. Look, the fact is New South Wales and Victoria are so interreliant on each other. The two biggest economies. You know, when we were flying, the Sydney to Melbourne air route was the second busiest air route in the world. Mm. And we actually share a significant border. When you think about those community towns of Albury, Wodonga, Echuca, Moama, even Mulwala, Yarrawonga, those communities are so interlinked. All but for a river, the mighty Murray, we are just one state. So it makes sense to actually have the same settings across all of Victoria and New South Wales once we get to the 70% double vaccination rates and then beyond.
Gladys and Daniel Andrews are unlikely bedfellows, if I can put it that way. But do you think you have the support of his government and your fellow Victorians?
Look, Dan and I talk, you know, probably three times a week, and we think through this. We would hope our political leaders would be doing the same thing. At the end of the day, health advice is health advice, and as I said before, we're only separated by the mighty Murray, which is about 50 metres wide. So surely the health advice on the New South Wales side and the health advice on the Victorian side need to align.
That's the only way
we're going to be able to move forward. Yeah, that's right. We need to give businesses the confidence, particularly as we come into Christmas period. We know on the New South Wales side of the Murray there, they're so reliant on Victorian visitors. We need to be able to start planning.
Have you had any response from either government yet?
We've spoken to our state, and as everybody knows, this afternoon we'll know what the response is going to be. We hope it's good news, but you know, we wait somewhat nervously, I think.
Yeah. Well, so what's the next step to make this happen before Christmas and to give businesses hope and families the opportunity to see each other again?
Look, I think it's about getting certainty around those dates, giving some certainty, government's giving some certainty to both New South Wales and Victorians that when we hit those vaccination rates at 70%, we can broaden those border bubbles, as Paul said, around those border communities so they can trade normally and be and actually live normally. And then around that, giving some certainty at 80% that we can fully open up. People can plan, people can book flights for Christmas. They can go to those tourist spots on the border towns. So it's about giving certainty when we hit 70% and 80%. And as I said, like both governments actually have some degree of certainty over those dates that they're going to hit those rates.
Yeah.
And we should be able to lock those away now. Businesses are people. It's people's life's work. It gets people moving. People are suffering out there, and we need to give them some certainty.
Paul, New South Wales has way more cases. Would Victorians be okay with that?
I think so. I mean, it all relies on the vaccination rates, Sophie, and we're about 10 or 11% behind where New South Wales are right now. We need to get that accelerated up. You know, we look to other parts of the world, and we know as they've hit different levels of vaccination, it's keeping people out of hospital, and that's really important through this. So we've got to find a way to drive the vaccination rates up, and that's what Dan and I are saying. Let's base this based on vaccination rates, and when we hit the 70% and then 80% double vax, we should be right to go. We know the hospitals will have a load, but we know through the National Cabinet framework and the Doherty Institute modelling, that's going to be manageable once we hit that 70% and 80% level.
Yeah.
I think I've walked every inch of my 5K zone, so a trip to Melbs would be great.
Yeah, we like the way you think, gentlemen. Middle of October, 4 weeks, let's go.